After meeting up in Lima, Brandon and I headed for Iquitos, in the heart of the Amazon. Iquitos is the largest city in the world, completely unreachable by road. Although relatively secluded from the world, this Amazonian city hosts over 3,400 residents. The city gained its wealth and grew rapidly in the late 1800s and early 1900s during the rubber boom. Today, this city continues to thrive off the Amazon and has become the main gateway for those wanting to reach the Amazon River. Though third world in nature, this city is still quite beautiful. Brandon and I did our best to explore and meet as many of the locals as possible, even taking the local transportation, a moto taxi, to explore. Jumping from museum, back to plaza, back to another museum, Brandon and I did our best to absorb the Amazonian culture during our time spent here. But that's just the beginning. The real adventure was just about to begin. The Amazon, the world's largest tropical rainforest. Spanning over 2 million square miles, this rich ecosystem hosts over 40,000 plant species, 1,300 bird species, 3,000 types of fish, and 430 mammals. Referred to as the lungs of the earth, the rich vegetation here filters out more than 20% of the world's oxygen. It's said over one-fifth of all water that runs off the earth's surface is carried by the Amazon. Maybe that's why the Amazon is 4,000 miles in distance. Much of our adventure here was spent trudging through the Amazon jungle, machete in hand, of course. And despite the dangers, it was our manliness that allowed us to survive. Give me your fiercest warrior look.
You're not gonna get a fierce warrior look from me.
We have a giant crater to cross. Our guide Raphael is going once, going twice.
And he makes it
across. He's coming back. Just so he can show us how it's done.
You gonna jump
off? Stay there, yeah.
Okay.
Here he goes.
No stress.
Woo. Brandon Parr's going. Going once. He makes it. Our guide Raphael taught us much, including how to use sap from this tree as a propellant to start a fire even in a wet area. Next, we found the bullet ant.
But ant eater, this is the one favorite food for ant eater. They don't need to eat thousands, millions.
The bullet ant, a normally non-aggressive ant until you shove a stick into their nest, has one of the most painful stings in the world, causing agonizing pain for 24 hours if stung. Next came the rains. A place that lacks a dry season and is more aptly described as either the wet or wetter season, rain is a daily part of life in the Amazon where nothing you own is ever dry again.
Our weather forecast for today is spotty with possible showers.
Awesome.
This is my friend Zach and companion. If you're looking for a new rain jacket, this is the one to buy. I don't really have a rain jacket on, even though it looks like it.
I'm in between.
My friend Brandon, he's doing alright.
With over 120 inches of rain a year, this place is called the rainforest. Sky is clear and life emerges once again, like this little guy, the yellow poison dart frog. Considered to be one of the most toxic animals on earth, he holds enough poison to kill 10 grown men, the perfect substance for the indigenous people to use for their blow dart guns. Oh, did you see that? Looks like this little guy just got a snack. Let's watch that again. Truly remarkable. Not too far away, his cousin, the red poison dart frog, shows up. Not quite as graceful. His counterpart is all the same just as toxic. scientists are still unsure what makes these little frogs so poisonous. If raised in captivity, they never develop poison. Yes, a question to ponder for another day. The Amazonian people are quite amazing. Simple by nature, they know how to use the jungle in the most effective way. Our guide is an educated local that grew up in the Amazon. His countenance reminded us of something that we could just not put our finger on, though. Maybe it was the way he pondered the jungle. He used the forces around him, and he swung that machete in just the most recognizable way. We tried to keep up, but we were no match for this Amazonian native. During our exploration here, we did our best to make as many friends as possible. Like this dung beetle, this army ant, a bird, but not so much the fish. They seem to like to bite back. A sphinx caterpillar, a 10-foot emerald boa constrictor, and of course, the infamous black caiman, the ruler of these waters. Look at this, it's the smallest monkey in the world, a pygmy marmoset. Averaging only 6 inches in size, this little guy is able to leap 15 feet into the air. That's equivalent to a 6-foot tall man jumping 174 feet. Truly remarkable. Going upward, we climb to the top of the canopy. Up here, the trees seem to even put up a fight, but not quite enough for this little guy. Can you see him? This annoying lizard loves the view up here almost as much as we do. And how could we take a trip to the Amazon and forget to mention the slumbering sloth? Well, not this guy. He was surprisingly active. Sloths absolutely love the tops of the trees. The best place to bask in the sun and take a nap. Did you hear that? The whistling actually attracts them. Yes, our trip to the Amazon was simply awe-inspiring. The precious nature of life as we know it is put in front of you in a way, here, that is like no other. They fully attest to what the Bible says, like in Romans chapter 1 and verse 20. For his invisible qualities are clearly seen from the world's creation onward, because they are perceived by the things made, even his eternal power and Godship, so that they are inexcusable.